Hello, walkers. Today we are going to try another coastal walk. We're going to start out by the seawall here in Cullen. You can see it's kind of high tide. I'm going to take you down along the coast, and I'm going to try and find Findlater Castle, which is this ruin of castle that I think you'll enjoy. Not sure I'll find it or stay out of the rain. It's supposed to be rainy all day, but it's not too bad right now. And then, depending on what trails I can find, we may go over to Sand's End, I think is a little town, a little beach town, even smaller than Cullen. So we're gonna give it a shot and see what we can find and see how dry we can stay. If you get a chance, we are spending a month here in Scotland. Check out Traveling Mel, that channel on YouTube, if you like family travel content. I'm going to be starting to post Scotland videos there soon, finishing up our Montana winter and spring trips. Also, if you like nature footage, just sort of ambient nature for sleeping or relaxing, check out Amazing Nature Relaxation Therapy. I know it's a long name, but it's just a little side project I'm working on. I'll try to remember to link to those in the description below. I will also try to keep the lens clean, but it's a little tough with the wind and the rain. I believe up here somewhere in these buildings is the Cullen Hostel. Yeah, there it is, right up there. You can see the sign. I'm gonna duck through here, see what I can see over this way. Oh, it's walled off. We came the opposite way on our Cullen walk, which I think I just posted today. But we're going to keep going out along this path past the little pet cemetery at the base of these cliffs. Here's the Cullen Hostel. In here. Pretty kind of neat little fisherman cottage style building right next to the sea. Oh, look at that. It's beautiful. This particular trail is also labeled as the Salmon Bothy Walk, and I think a Salmon Bothy was a place where they processed salmon. A small place, not like a cannery. Give out my $6 umbrella. Give that a shot. See how long it lasts. Aye, aye, aye. Not long. believe the salmon bothy might be up that way. And I've been told that I should stay straight here onto this smaller path. All right. Beautiful flowers in the gorse. these purple flowers, beautiful. Thank you. Oh wow, look at this. Guess we're gonna go down here. Whoa, slippery. Big steps. Very cool. Little sketchy here. Not really that sketchy. This steep. Erected by the people of Cullen to remember Tony Hetherington, who built these steps single-handed in 1987. That's pretty impressive. Gonna go out to Charlie's Cave. Read about this in one of the history books. Well, I didn't read about it, I looked at the pictures. That's what we do these days. Not sure if I missed it or not. Could be hidden by this gorse. I suspect it's in here, or was. I'll try to find a link online that talks about it and put it in the description below. That looks like about it. On we go. I believe that beach up ahead is Sunnyside Beach. go this way. Some oyster catchers up ahead. There they go. Vibrant orange bills. Thank you. Apparently the path has been damaged up here, so we'll have to be careful. That's not so bad. Thank you. right, here we go. You can kind of see it down there in the end of that spit of land. Man, that must have been a bleak place to live in the Middle Ages or medieval times. 1800 to 1200 AD, I think. I'll try to put a link in the description below. Here's a board. Century, actually. I'll give you just a little glimpse of what it looked like, supposedly. And then that's what it looks like now. Can't tell if there's a path, but I believe there is, so we'll go down there. Slippery. This mud is really slippery. So if I plummet to my death, I did it all for you. I'm gonna try not to do that though. Oop. Oh, it's beautiful out here. Look at all these flowers, amazing castles, stunning cliff along the sea, birds flying everywhere. This is why we travel. close. Here we go. We'll go see that in a minute. I think we can get down there. Oh my gosh, guys. I'm so glad you are here to join me with this. And we're not quite done, so stick around for the next few minutes. So we're gonna go down into this castle. There's a path down in here. And what's crazy to me, you would never see this in the States, is there's no signs saying do not enter, don't be a dummy. It's kind of left up to you to have some common sense or not. Look at that. Oh my gosh. You know, to each their own. That's a doozy. I could hop down in there, but I don't want to. Sorry. All right, everybody. That's pretty amazing. Pretty amazing stuff. I think that I'm gonna just call it here. I hope you've enjoyed this walk. Please leave a comment with what you liked, what you didn't like. Also, suggestions of other places I can go while I'm in Scotland. We're up between Aberdeen and Inverness. We do have a car, but we don't want to drive too far. We'll try and get up into the Cairngorms in the next week or so. Over to Inverness, maybe down to Aberdeen, and a couple other local towns, and of course a few more of these coastal walks. Please let me know, do you like the coastal walks? I love them. I can start adding in more nature hiking type of walks very easily. We do that on our own anyway. So please leave a comment below. Give us a thumbs up. Hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. And click the little bell. That gives you a notification whenever I post. I'm going to try to post a little bit more frequently since I'm having so many walking opportunities here, at least for a little while. So hopefully people will like that. And in the meantime, happy walking. I hope you enjoyed this. Hope you have some great walks on your own or just on your treadmill, however you're doing this. We'll talk to you later in a couple days.